a laugh in your face. And who you think people are going to get right on you? Your friend.
Amen.
You close with them. But let me tell you something, baby. The white spice is the food. The Bible said that the sword that you take out for me is going to pierce into your own heart. That's, I'm talking healing today.
Amen.
The same sword that you take to put on me, that sword is going to be broken in your heart. The bone arrow you got put line up for me, and I'm talking to you too. You saying the same thing as I'm saying. That bone is going to be broken.
Amen.
Because the Bible is clear. No weapon.
Yes.
Form against you should prosper. Mess up my mind. But let me tell you something, my mind, I don't have my own mind, I have the mind of Christ. Somebody say the mind of Christ. See, when you have the mind of Christ, nobody can do you anything. We all need to have the mind of Christ. We need to wake to have the mind of Christ. That's why they look to see you when they think you're thinking, yeah, this will be the end of him. It's not going to be the end of me, baby, because guess what? I read something with somebody who ever made up his bulletin. I want to read this quickly. I'm not going to stop till I'm done. The bulletin says, you know what the bulletin says? Which is so powerful. When I read it, I said, wow, isn't this awesome? I asked for strength, and God gave me difficulties to make me strong. I asked for strength, and God gave me difficulties.
Yeah, strong.
I asked for wisdom, and God gave me problems. I asked for prosperity, and God gave me brains and brand to work. I asked for courage, and God gave me danger to overcome. I asked for love, and God gave me troubled people to work to help me. Troubled people for me to help.
Amen.
I asked for favors, and God gave me opportunities. I received nothing I wanted. I received everything I needed.
Amen.
So we need to, when we put these things in the bulletin, sometimes we just got to take it along and find time to read it, because anything that is put any place for you to read can help you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So while you're asking, God, I want you to give me increase. God said, yeah, I'm going to give you what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you a field. The field is white.
Yes.
It's ready for harvest.
Yes.
You say, God, I want this to happen. God said, if you want it to happen, then I'm going to give you the field. God, you said, I want money. And God said, you want money, then I'm going to give you a job. I'm going to give you work.
Amen.
And that's how God works. So if you want healing, you're not going to get healing until you'll be immersed in the word of God. You're not going to get healing until you get connected to him. The woman with the issue of blood, she didn't get no healing until she touched on him.
Amen.
We got to touch the hem of God's garment.
Yes.
I don't care what happened in my past. Like, I don't care what the devil say about me. I'm going to stay connected to God. Somebody say connected. No belt holding nobody in this church. This is a free church. When you're ready, you can say, I'm God. You come, you're heartily welcome. We love you. Long as you're here, we love you. When you go, we still love you. But you don't need to feel that you're blind to be here. You gotta be free wherever you go. You gotta be free. Somebody say free.
Free.
Yeah. Come on, somebody say, well, I don't like how we talking. But let me tell you something, I am talking as the Spirit leads me.
Yeah.
You may say, that you don't want to be here, and guess what? You ain't being here, you don't want to be here, you want your entrance anyway.
Amen.
See, God ain't gonna wait with people until they're in agreement. Somebody say agreement.
Amen.
The Bible said, unless two agree, guess what? Nothing can happen unless two agree. When you walk in, God was blessing. When you walk out, God can still bless. Somebody say yes.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes.
Be afraid. Oh, your word got power. My word got power, because guess what? God, Jesus said, the Bible says, he perceived. And he said, why reasoning in your hearts where I can forgive sin or not?
Uh-huh.
The same God in Jesus is in me. He said, I in you and God in me.
Amen.
So if you don't love where you are, you don't feel comfortable here, say goodbye. And that's what people do. And guess what? They're happy. And guess what? You know what we got to do? Those of us who remain, we got to stay focused.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. There's a big pulpit out there. And God doesn't show me there's a big pulpit out there. Nobody can call them there. I turn on my radio, I look on the TV, I'm getting ready to close. I turn on the TV and guess what I see? I see the number man said, every half hour I can spend.
I know.
Every half hour I can drop a ball. And they got people there on that TV just watching that TV Nobody complained about them other than all the gambling people. So when we take our microphone and get out there and start voicing up the atmosphere and start voicing up what the devil doing out there, I want them to complain then.
Yeah.
But we know that God said you want this, we'll get out there and start preaching.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And so I got news for you, baby. I got news for you. Yeah. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Because the devil is defeated. Somebody said defeated. Somebody say healer.
Yeah.
That's how it is. We just got to begin to trust God. And I talk about healing today because some of you in here may be sick.
Amen.
You may be sick. Amen. Now, God will take away your sickness. I'm getting ready to close. God will take away your sickness. And he will not put diseases on you. Those diseases are for people who hate God. The people who hate God, they're running around going to these funny people. My brother talked about they're being in a funny place, and the man said, put them do this and you can find a ring someplace and everything, they do all these wicked things. Honey, you think if that man was truly gonna make money, he would have been poor?
No, no.
He's trying to make money if you're talking crazy, but he can make you rich.
Amen.
If you can make somebody rich, make yourself rich.
Amen.
The only person who can make us rich is God. Anything you get in God ain't given to you, it comes with sorrow. I can tell you, if you get a little bit God, I'm just stop you with me this morning. You get a little bit God, one little bit God. That's better than a bunch of stuff with the devil.
Yeah.
I'd rather be in the house of God among the people of God and with a few than to be in a house with a bunch of devils. Somebody say yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. The Bible said, two or three of you shall gather together, touching anything in my name. He said, there I am in the midst of bless. If you come expecting something, you will get something.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Some people don't even show up on the ground. You know something? This church was full and I was talking like this. They said, yeah, look at him showing off.
My Lord.
When the church is empty, I preach. When he's full, I preach. And they said, he's showing off.
Yeah.
He laughing now. Yesterday, it looked like he was crying. I don't be crying, I be praying.
Amen.
The Bible bids us to pray without ceasing, Brother John. Pray without ceasing. Somebody say ceasing.
Ceasing.
You want to stand up and you know sometimes you can stand up and raise your hand and say yes, Lord, and then not sleep and go.
Yeah.
We got to pray without ceasing.
Amen.
For the Bible says the effectual and the fervent prayer of a righteous man or a woman availeth much.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So God got to take away the sickness, and he promised he will not put any of the diseases of the Egyptians upon you. Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 15 says, and the Lord will take away from thee
all
sickness. How much sickness?
All.
Come on, somebody. How much sickness?
All.
So if you're sick, you got to know this voice.
Amen.
The side of Satan is Egypt.
Yeah.
The people in the world, those sickness here for you. Those are the world sickness. That's what comes to the people who are there in the world, following after the world system, the Babylonian system. He said, I will take away from thee all sickness and will put none of these evil diseases of Egypt. God put those sickness on them.
Yeah.
He put them on them.
Yeah.
Which thou knowest. You know about them because when you was in the world, you knew there was sickness. When you come to God, you should understand that there is no sickness. God said, I will lay down upon all them that hate you. See, the people who hate me, they're in trouble. The people who I hate, I'm in trouble.
Yeah.
That's why I try not to hate people.
Amen.
The Bible, you know why God tells us, Jesus said, love your enemies.
Yes.
Do good to them that hate you. Bless them that curse you. and pray for them that despitefully use you. Love your enemy. Why are you going to love? He said, love and hate not. The reason why you're going to hate not, he said, I will put all of the evil diseases, I will put all the sickness upon them that hate you. So when you hate someone, particularly if they are God's people, you are asking for all the sickness of the world to come on you.
Amen.
So if you hate someone, especially, you should hate no one, but especially a child of God, a man or woman of God, you need to release that right now. Because what happens is that you're going to get sick. Disease is going to hit you.
Yes.
Cleanse yourself right now. How many of you hate someone in this room? Raise your hand if you hate someone. Yes, I see that hand. Yes, I see that hand. That's the hand of the devil I see. But the devil is a liar. Somebody says, Satan is defeated.
Satan.
So God will give us healing. He is our doctor.
Yes.
This is not just a tool. He's a doctor that never loses a patient. Some people think that this is only a talk. This is not only a talk, baby. This is a walk.
Yes.
How many people God ever heal in this room? Raise your hand if he ever heal you. Hallelujah. She says he can give you a greater healing. Hallelujah. God is going to heal some of us in this room right now.
Amen.
Right now, right now. If he wants to do it again, and you want to do it again, and he wants to do it again. The next thing, God is the one that heals us. God is the one that heals us. Why does he tell us he's not going to put sickness on us? He's not going to put any diseases on us. He's going to put that on the people who hate us. And now we see who it is that truly heals us. Read Exodus 15 and 26. It says, and said,
If thou wilt diligently
hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and will do that which is right in his sight,
and
will give ear to his commandments,
and
keep all his statutes, I will put none of these diseases upon thee which I have brought upon the Egyptians, for I am the Lord that healeth thee. I am the Lord that healeth thee. I quote these all the time. I am the Lord that healeth thee. And God is not going to put any sickness on you. But you got to have faith. You got to believe. You got to quote his word. He said, if my word abide in you, and you abide in my word, you will ask whatsoever you will, and it shall be done. God honors his word. Somebody, let me tell you. God honors his word above his name, and God watches over his word to perform it. I want to ask the next question. How do we get this healing? How do we get healing from God?
Faith.
We get healing by God from God in several ways. One of the most, the biggest ways, and faith is the thing that girls, we gotta ride our healing on faith. Alright? Faith is the substance of things so far, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is knowing that something has happened before it even happens. You gotta know it's happening. That's why when I talk, you say, I am always talking and nothing happened. But see, while you say nothing is happening in my soul and in my spirit, I already know what is gonna happen because I have faith. I see it afar off. I see it. Some people die in faith, but nevertheless, they have their faith until they die. And what they said was gonna happen, it occurred.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So we gotta have faith. I believe that God can heal me, and I'm gonna do this all day. I believe so you got body, I have no body. Oh, you can give you all, I all, but you say I all, but guess what? That's what you say, but that ain't what I know better. Because I have faith to believe I can do this all day without getting tired. I can do this all day. How do you get it? You gotta exercise.
Amen.
You gotta exercise your faith. Yeah. Somebody say exercise.
Exercise.
You gotta exercise your faith. Some people say, oh, it's just gonna happen. No, baby. Exercise and faith means when the devil come to you, you will say, get behind me, Satan. Mine. Sometime, you may have a lapse. You may have a lapse. But when you have that lapse, when that green light turn on and say, boy, you sin, you got to get to your knees and say, Father, I sin. Please forgive me.
Amen.
Cleanse me. Oh Lord, I'm sorry. I repent. Put that behind you in the sea of forgetful. We are never rises to condemn you no more. And keep pressing your way. Hold your faith in God. Faith can beat out everything. I'm a living witness. I believe faith is going to win out in every situation. So by our faith. This woman who we've seen this morning had an issue of blood. She crept up behind Jesus. Couldn't get in by the doctors. The doctors only can give you medicine. They only can put you in a machine called the what? That big machine they lay you down in?
X-ray.
Not X-ray. What worse than that? The scan MRIs, even you put that, and they put you inside there. You go in there and you're so scared. You can't move and you're in that big thing. They put me in it before. They slide in there and they tell me don't breathe. Keep still. I said, now Jesus, I said, what's going to happen if I breathe? And you want to scream, but you dare not scream inside that thing. And let me tell you something. That don't heal. That don't save you. That don't heal you. They had a little operation on my knee. Several years ago, and guess what? When they take that thing out, some people say, man, and you the next day I was doing this. Because you know why? I realized the doctor only could cut me, tear open my skin, take something out with God and show me that he was going to heal anyway. But I decided I'll go, he takes it out, and I realized that only God could heal me.
Amen.
When God heal you, you're a human being. God has blessed. I hear God say that to someone this morning. Who God bless? Listen to me. Who God bless? No man can curse. You want to know a man who God bless? He will always try to curse someone who God bless. Always. All them granny children. Them, them granny children this, granny children that. But when God bless them, no matter what they say, God says, I am blessed them. And guess who God is blessed? You all go and sleep on me. You all should be listening. I want you all to hear me. Word of faith, you all hear me? You all just grab a little piece I tell you, you all going to be all right. God can bless people who everyone try to say nothing will happen for them.
Amen.
The cheering ain't amount up to nothing. This ain't going to happen for them. The next one ain't going to happen for them. But God bless whoever he wants to bless. And when God blesses a person, no man can curse them. And guess what? When God curses somebody, oh God, tonight you're supposed to be on the radio, but I didn't get the thing. See, the Spirit just tells me now. You're supposed to be on the radio tonight. I was supposed to have the thing to say LNS, but I haven't it. So we ain't coming on today. So Robin, what I need you to do from here on in, hallelujah. Robin, record the service from start to finish, all right? That's where I could just go back and record and send it to ZLS, because you just bring in the preaching, I need it from start to finish, the praise and worship, everything. So when I need something to send to ZLS, I'll have it, record it, amen?
Amen.
Let's close now. And so therefore, we get our healing by faith, having faith in God. The woman said, if I can only touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole. Amen?
Yes.
The next minute we can get healing, he said, if any among you sick, they called for everybody, this one can pray for me. The next one pray for me. I want pastor to pray for me. I even want pastor to know I'm sick. That can't be of God.
No.
See, God have a way working for you to heal him. Oh, I can call for the brother to pray for me. He can pray for you fine. But God said you must pray for one another.
Amen.
That your sins may not be blotted out. But when it comes to healing, guess what God says? Is any sin among you? Huh? Let him what? Call for the elders of the church. And let them do what? Pray over him. Anointing him with oil. In the name of? And the prayer of faith will heal the sick. And the Lord will raise them up.
Amen.
When you're sick, you're supposed to run the call for the pastor.
Yes.
You're supposed to run the call for the elder boy. So that you can get that prayer. And then that prayer of faith is going to heal you. And the Lord will raise you up.
Yeah.
And the good thing about it, if you commit a sin, it will be no giving of you. Some people just have a, listen baby, you know. you. But remember, God will never put anyone any place and don't give them some guidance on what to do.
Amen.
But just we just need to begin to have faith in what God is doing and stop putting our faith and our confidence in ourselves.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be close. Be closing right here. I think that's it. I hope that's it. Hallelujah. Call for the elders of the church. You said that already, didn't we?
Yes.
And then, what is the hindrance to lack of healing? The hindrance to lack of healing is your own doubts.
Yes.
Your own doubts. My honey was sick yesterday a little bit. I said, David, don't you feel too well? No. I said, but let me go get something for you. You can take it here. When I give her that stuff, I said, baby, are you feeling better? She said, I'm feeling a little better. She rallied around because why? She had faith to believe.
Yes.
Ain't nothing to do with it. If I had given her a piece of rock and it looked like a prince and she'd take that, she'd have been all right. Because healing really is a state of your heart, is a state of your mind. If you do not have faith in anything, you're not going to get any healing. But remember that all healing comes from God.
Yes.
The medicine will do no healing for you. It is God who gives you that healing.
Yes.
I like to do this. I like to do this. Why? Because I realize that only God can give you help.
Amen.
Only God can give you strength. But the more you trust Him, the more you put your confidence and your hope in Him, the more He's going to strengthen you. Finally, sin. Sin. Most people sick. They're sick because they're in sin. Sin is a sure way for you to get sick. If I were you, I would abandon my sin. Well, what kind of sin? I'm not going to call out any name. You know sin, and I know it. You need to let go of sin. Somebody say sin.
Sin.
You know what about? You know what? When the devil tried to tempt me, say, "Ah, you all the one people. The devil don't tempt you." Guess what? The devil more rather tempt me a old person than tempt you a young person. The reason why he want to tempt me a older person is because he know my time here ain't long. So he figured if he can tempt me and get me to the crisis hell, he only got me 10 more years and I'm gone, or 20, and he said, I'm going with you. He can give you a lot of rope to mess up yourself, as he said, let them go there, they're going to hackle up themselves. But anyhow, I ain't need to do much to them, because they're going to drive full speed.
Yeah.
Get that bike and they're going to bump that bike. They're going to, one day I expect them to crash into the lamp pole. That's what he's thinking. Yeah, I'm going to tempt them too much. All I got to do is put a drink of liquor in the front of them, because they're going to drink so much, and they're going to drink so much that they're going to get the harvest, and I got to worry about them, but not a one of them in the grave. I'm going to put doubt in their mind. I'm going to let them feel some pain. I want them to really start to doubt. I'm going to ask them, is there really a God? And then you got to say in your mind, the fool that said in your heart, there is no God. Hallelujah. The Lord has been in the temple. I'm going to ask an old woman a question. I don't even know she's mother.
Dawkins.
I went to her and I said, I didn't know who she was. I had a spirit to ask her the question. I said, Mother Dawkins, do you still have feelings for man? And I said, God, what did I ask this woman? You know what she told me? I have feelings for God. I have feelings for the church. I have feelings to go on convention. I have child. My husband leave me. I don't want to see no man. And when the Lord finished, the Lord said, what you did is you revealed her heart to herself. You know what she didn't do? She didn't know me and I didn't know her. If that was somebody who had something bad in their heart, it would have come out. And guess what? The minute she done say, the only I said, I tore them tents behind me long time because I wanted to find out. I was telling this old woman, I wanted to find out what was in her head, in her mind. And she said, I have mine for Christ. I have mine for convention. I have mine for church. And the minute she said that, someone called and said, hey, Pastor Newton. And I believe she said, God, I thank you because you don't know who's who. I want all of you to understand that people will be questioning you, people will be doing things to you as a child of God just to try to see what in your heart.
Yeah.
But honey, let me tell you something. If you ain't nothing in my heart, I don't care what you do. You can walk around here in crinoline. You can put on your crinoline and walk around, and guess what, you're on? You and your crinoline look like sin to me. Somebody say yes.
Yes.
Something. Why do you think these people walk around with these? Jesus. I don't know why. Somebody help me. They just dress all kind of old, walk up today, and I don't know why they do it. But it's sickening that they allow the devil to let them expose themselves like that. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So God is saying He want to heal, He want to deliver, and He want to set free. They're one in this room.